Please call roll.
Mr. Brown?
Aye.
Ms. Halagus?
Here.
Mr. Rader?
Here.
Mr. Nichols?
Here. Need approval of the September 25th minutes, please. Need a motion and a second?
I'd like to make a motion that we approve the minutes.
I'll second the motion.
Got a motion and a second. Any changes or anything to the minutes? Not, all right, please call roll.
Mr. Brown?
Yes.
Ms. Halagus?
Yes.
Mr. Rader?
Yes.
Mr. Nichols?
Yes. We have consent agenda item 2A, B, C, D, E, and F. Would anyone like to move any of those items from the consent agenda?
I would like to make a motion that we approve the consent agenda as it.
Okay, I got a motion, and I need a second.
He's like, whoop, whoop.
Excuse me, I'm running the meeting. Time out. I got a motion, and I got a second.
Yeah, I'll second. I thought she did. I thought you did.
You got a second?
I'm sorry.
No, it's...
Okay, then I'll second them. Yes, we make the motions first, and then...
You got a motion and a second?
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
So, yes. Second.
Yeah, I'm...
Yes, sir.
I'd like to, I would like to remove them all. I have a, from the consent agenda, with the exception of the St. Andrews Historic Waterfront Partnership, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, and D. Can we start with?
No, sir, I have a motion to approve all of them and a second to approve them. Would any of the commissioners like to move any of those items from the agenda, from the consent agenda? Okay. No, sir, call roll.
Oh. Mr. Brown? Ms. Halligan?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Rader?
Yes.
Mr. Nichols?
Yes. Okay. We're at new business, and I guess we have a presentation from S and M&E about the St. Andrews plan update.
That's correct. So I'd like to bring George Kramer forward. He's the representative from S and M&E to give a brief presentation.
Great.
Good morning.
Good morning. Appreciate the opportunity to be here today. We got into town yesterday, and we're really excited about kicking off the process and working with you all in the St. Andrews community. I just want to briefly talk through the process we're going to go through and answer any questions you might have. But I did want to share with you three observations we had from our conversations yesterday. First, it's really apparent the history and character of St. Andrews, and that's something that's really special and unique, and we'll be looking to build upon that throughout the process. The second, and related to that, is there's a really strong community support and spirit. You know, we heard some of the stories about the early days of the CRA when, you know, there wasn't a lot of money, a lot of TIF revenue, but there was a lot of sweat equity that was put in to help improve the district. And so that's always really important. I mean, the money and the infrastructure projects are important, but having that community spirit and to advance the district is an important component of that. And related to that, third is just the momentum. You know, we're fortunate to work in CRAs throughout the state, and a lot of times we're brought in to kind of start that fire and try to just, you know, where can you get a spark somewhere. There's some really strong momentum, as you all know, in the district now. And so it's kind of fun, you know, there's a decent amount of TIF revenue now. And so it's to look at, you know, how do we build upon that? So it's always nice to come in and recognize there's existing momentum, existing support within the district, and we're looking to build upon that. So really had a great first day, and I'll, you know, again, I'll briefly walk us through the process here that we'll be going through over the next few months. So again, my name is George Kramer. I'm the Director of Planning at SNME. Our office is based in Orlando. John Jones, our project manager, had a conflict, couldn't be here today, but I'm also joined with Adeline Collot, who's will be the project planner for this effort. So we're in task one now, that kickoff and data review. So of course, we're looking at existing plans. I think it's important, too. We're not throwing out the entire previous plan. There's still things that can and should be carried over. It is a comprehensive update, so we'll be looking at all those elements. But part of the effort is reviewing old plans and including the existing redevelopment plan. The second task is in public involvement. We'll be back here, I believe December 7th was the date that we decided on yesterday to come back to have a community open house and workshop and solicit input. Currently, we're working on some one-on-one stakeholder discussions with community members identified by city staff.
I have a question.
Sure.
If I can ask, I don't mean to interrupt you.
It's okay.
When you have a public involvement type thing that mm-hmm. you're talking about, later on, right?
Correct.
Would that be take place here, or do you know would that take place in your district?
Wherever
what?
They do.
How does that work? I mean,
you know, we could certainly do either or. I think it's always helpful to have the public involvement take place in the district that you're planning.
Okay, I didn't know because yeah. I don't remember going through one of these. Forgive me, Commissioner Nichols, for a CRA update.
I don't know, but this is awesome.
I don't remember how if we've done one of these like this, and forgive me.
Yeah, I'm not sure the process that you went through previously. So
I would see.
It's good that we're doing it.
Yeah, I'm glad we are. Yeah, so that's why it's a little bit new to me. So forgive me.
No, not a problem. So you know, after those first two initial tasks, we get through that public involvement. We'll start to generate some. Drafts of the plan to get input. The way we approach redevelopment plans, and I'll just kind of give you an outline of the strategy up front, is there are kind of two components. One, we want to, you know, like CRAs, like your local government, like the businesses you're a part of, right, no one has unlimited funds. So we need to be strategic and thoughtful about, okay, you know, there's a lot of needs, there's a lot of great ideas and projects, but which ones go first? And so, you know, we take a lot of time to develop a strategy of, okay, you know, what are the type of projects that are going to create some momentum, we talk about catalyst projects and those kind of things. You know, so how can we prioritize those and have a discussion with the community about that? But secondly, of course, once you have a redevelopment plan and it's adopted, that is the rule book, so to speak, on what you can spend money on. So at the same time, we want to be real comprehensive and sometimes somewhat general in the language to provide you with ultimate flexibility, because conditions are going to change and some projects are going to come up 3 years down the line that we didn't necessarily anticipate, and we want to provide you with that flexibility to be able to adjust to that down the line. So, you know, we're going to have a strategy in there, you know, looking at that 3 to 5 year time frame, but at the same time, we want to be comprehensive in our goals, objectives, and policies for the redevelopment plan. So our schedule now takes us through presenting a draft plan probably in February and adoption somewhere around April. So, you know, hoping to wrap the project up within the first quarter of next year. And I kind of went through all these, but these are just kind of the detail. Again, we're there on the second subtask there. I want to take you, you know, and again, I mentioned before, you know, there's a good amount of money here already, and so that's a really good thing, and we can start to look at some impactful infrastructure projects. One of the things that we think is really important as part of our community involvement is, you know, so you all have to deal with and CRA business on a day-to-day basis. You understand how TIF revenue is generated. Oftentimes, when we go out to the public, you know, they understand what the needs of the community are, but they don't understand how the TIF, tax increment financing works. And so we try to spend a little bit of time at the front end talking about that process so that your constituents have an understanding of the decisions that you have to make and why you might be strategic and that there's a really good project, but that's probably a latter phase project as opposed to a project that's up front. You know, you can see here, this is one of the graphics we use to demonstrate, you know, that base year, and then the green and the blue areas are that increment that we're able to utilize for the process. So that's just one of the elements that we'll be doing.
Just out of curiosity,
sure.
The pictures on there, what do they each symbolize?
Which
when you went back,
these? Okay, so the house there would be, you know, neighborhoods, residential.
Okay.
So, you know, cars, transportation, the maps, maybe wayfinding, the piggy bank, I think just demonstrates funding.
Because you like pigs.
The funding.
Just kidding.
We've got another street on there. Adeline, you can help me. What is the second to last one on there? That's a good question.
No big deal.
We're going to get back to you on that one.
No big deal. I was just curious. Is that kind of an order of operations?
It is the menu of options, right?
Oh, okay.
So infrastructure gets a lot of attention. But, you know, grant programs are really important. So, you know, there's policies, programs, and projects, so to speak. And so those are really the menu of options that we have, you know, for investment.
Thank you.
Okay. So, again, just the next steps will be, in addition to the public outreach, we'll be doing a website and online survey to collect data that way. You know, we think it's important. We know some people want to participate in person and provide the opportunity for that. Other people would rather just put their input online. And so, you know, we want to accept both of those feedbacks. Again, we'll be finalizing those goals, objectives, and policies throughout the public input process. We'll be making TIF projections based on anticipated growth rates. We'll have the budget and drafting those components. And again, we're targeting an April time frame to come back to you all for consideration and adoption. Now, of course, we'll be talking to you several times in between now and then, but you know, we think generally a six-month process is pretty good to get adequate input, but not to have a protracted process that kind of loses momentum. So, you know, again, we're really excited to be here. We've got another day of interviews here today. But at this time, you know, I'd be happy to answer any other questions you have about the process or about what we may have seen thus far.
How many people will be on your team, you know, as you go around speaking to stakeholders and, mm-hmm. you know, getting public input from the folks in that district?
Just from our consultant
yeah,
team?
Yeah, from your team.
Yeah, we'll have generally, you know, depending on the size of the workshop, you know, we can staff up. We've got six people within our planning department. Probably between three and four, you know, can handle up to, you know, a group of up to 100 people. If we thought we'd have more than that, we could staff up.
But you mentioned like one-on-one at times, mm-hmm. You know, which I think is good.
Yeah.
Getting down to the grassroots.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what we found is effective, and so again, city staff had helped us identify some of the community leaders and those who are more intimately knowledgeable about the aspects of the CRA, and so we had the opportunity to do those one-on-one interviews up front. That kind of gives us a good baseline of knowledge going into the public workshops.
Good. Well,
I am so proud that we're doing this, and I just think it's great. I'm wondering, can we continue to use them as a resource with all of our other CRAs? I mean, I'm serious. Like, we need, you know, this is somewhat, I mean, these are like, to me, it's kind of like urban planners within CRA districts, you know, that's what it sounds like.
Yeah.
And so I would love to, if things go well with this project, I think we should consider doing that even with downtown CRA. We've got, you know, we've got lots of CRAs, mm-hmm. Millville, we have a lot of CRAs, but that is, downtown North, I feel like they're just, you know.
Commissioner,
but,
actually. We
but I hope that we consider that.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, I'm done.
The FRA, the Florida Redevelopment Administration, recommends that we update our plans every 5 years. That hasn't been done in a lot of the districts that we've got, and we're getting on track to do that. So services similar to this,
we
do that in each of our districts.
Yeah, I just think it helps, like, being comprehensive like that and having real, you know, having direction, and it's great. I'm excited.
Well,
looking forward to it.
Well, thanks. We're excited too.
All right.
Chairman, as usual, Ms. Hellegass always steal my thunder.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But I was going to bring something like that up similar, and I understand that we're probably in the process of doing this because the Downtown North CRA is vastly approaching their time to renew. Like I said, I'm kind of adamant about getting ready, doing things way ahead of time, so we can get an assurance
that this CRA will be upgraded and also continue for the next section of time that we have. Because if you go back in history, I can remember when the Glenwood community first found out they was in the downtown CRA. 20 years had passed. Mm. And we've been vastly trying to come up, catch up, and started some things. Now, just like on this items on our list, well, I had some concerns about that, but I talked with the city manager today, and I'm going to talk with him some more. And we addressed half of these issues already. And we're going to meet again next week to keep bringing me up to date and keep me abreast of what things are going on. But I like to say that the Alley Crew is doing great. We increased funding for them. And we got the police department. They have got their $1 million stipend so they can continue and maintain. And we also, the memorandum of understanding for Legion Services, everything, all items on here has been advanced and getting better. And I'm very well pleased now with how we should say.
We started underground like a basketball. We kept shaking the dirt. Now the ball was just above the earth. We are doing great. We need to continue it. And
this was another thing that we need to bring up. And this 5-year deal we're coming, that 20 years will never come again with another CRA because we're keeping abreast with it. And I think we're doing great. And everything is doing good, and I would like to apologize to Mr. Swift when he wanted to come up and address the same thing that I did. I didn't see him approaching when I made my motion, and I just like to apologize on record. And we're doing great. We shaked all the dirt off. Now it's time for the community to get more involved, to come up and express your desires, express what you want in the CRA. But you still, this money out here is for doing infrastructure, making the area better so when you move your house into the community, the downtown North CRA, all communities, it will be ready for you to upgrade and build. And that's all I got to say right now.
Thank you.
Mr. Kramer, thank you, and we look forward to the St. Andrews updated plan, and the good news is that we're going to review all the plans on a 5-year basis. So thank you for starting this process for St. Andrews.
Our yes, pleasure. Thank you. Sure.
Okay. Appreciate it. At this time, we have public comment. If there's anyone that wishes to address the commission that has not already been discussed, do so at this time.
William Swift, Chairman of Glenwood Working Partnership, 1505 Dunnett Court, Lynn Haven, Florida. I accept your apology, Commissioner, for that. On the subject of what I wanted to ask there is that in reviewing all of these MOUs, there's a component in it that says that reporting will be done on either monthly, quarterly, or annual basis. And I'm curious as to where these reports can be found and if they're available to the public. And have you seen any of these reports? I've been looking for them in the CRA monthly updates. In the updates, and I haven't seen really the reports, so I'd like to know where they're available, and when they can be viewed. The second thing that I would like to address, and I addressed it at the last month's CRA meeting, was on the relocation of the people from Washington, Carver, and Roosevelt Avenues. I want to know what is the plan for that? We haven't seen any of the plan for the demolition or the relocation of houses or, you know, anything. We don't know really what's going on with the property at this point in time. And so if there's any way we can get to the plans, you know, going forward, you know, bids, that sort of thing, you know,
Jared,
going out.
What you got on that?
Let's let him give us 3 minutes.
And number three, I want to go back to the 163-360 community redevelopment plans. Seven, in 163-367, quote, following such hearing, the governing body may approve the community redevelopment and the plan. Therefore, if it finds that, A feasible method exists for the location of families who will be displaced from the community development area in decent, safe, and sanitary dwelling accommodations within their means and without undue hardship to the families. I want to get that read into the record again, because I don't think that that has happened in this redevelopment.
So I'll address the relocation plan. I'll address the relocation plan issue. We checked with the Florida Redevelopment Association. The way we purchased the property, the relocation plan was it was on the existing landlord. He used to provide relocation. That was the relocation plan. Sorry, the relocation plan was on the landlord, with the previous owner of the property. Because we bought that and expected all the properties to be vacant, he was. I think I changed the channel. I'm on 5-8.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me.
Here you go. Oh,
here you go. Jared, here you go, buddy.
So as far as the relocation plan goes, we checked with the Florida Redevelopment Administration. Because we purchased that property vacant, and we told the previous landowner prior to us purchasing the property that all the tenants needed to be out by then, they felt that that was a sufficient relocation plan, as that put that in the existing or the previous landlord's hands. So the relocation plan was the previous landowner was to relocate those residents. That sufficed for the Florida Redevelopment Administration or Association, excuse me. As far as the reports and availability, all those reports are available on our annual reports that we put out every year. Our annual report for this fiscal year will be out in March. The reporting requirements in these MOUs this year are a little bit different, and they're more involved than previous years. So we're actually asking for more from each of the departments that we do MOUs with. And that's just in line with what the state requires and what we've seen in legislation this past session. That they're going to increase reporting requirements, so we figured we need to go ahead and get ahead of that and increase our requirements as well. So some of those departments have the ability to report monthly because they consistently do monthly activities. Some of those departments, their lead time is a little bit longer to spend some of the money, and so they can only do quarterly because they'd have a couple of months where they'd say, well, there's nothing to report. So we tried to negotiate that and with each department what would work best for them.
And where, so when they do the quarterly reports or the monthly reports in these departments, where's those reports? Departments give it to staff. We put it on the web page for the CRAs. What do we do with those reports once we generate them?
Those reports right now are put in our updates, our monthly updates you guys receive.
So at the commission meetings, they're in that update.
And those are published reports.
And they're at the CRA office as well.
That's correct.
Very good.
Jared, what about the plan for Carver and stuff? I think he was asking about that too. Like, do we have a plan of what we are going to do with that property?
I'm not up to speed 100% with that, okay. But I'll find out immediately after the meeting.
Okay.
Mr. Mayor, I mean, Commissioner, Right now, as if you go through the area of Washington, Carver, and Roosevelt, you see that the houses are all boarded up to keep anything from coming out, because we, now that the city owns it, we don't want people coming in and getting in. If they break in, then I don't think that would be under the umbrella of the city. And the alley crew has been over there cleaning it up. They moved right into it. And I think we need to, I know we're increasing it now, but I think we need to increase the alley crew more. They're doing more. We need to get more equipment, more people. And like I said, the more we have, the quicker we can get the CRA cleaned up. Yeah. And we can start moving into areas where we kind of slow and behind on, and even if it's just for a year or two. And I can, I foresee that I have divisions, and I can see it's coming. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was a joke.
Any else, anyone else would like any make any public comments? All right. Not hearing any? Henry?
Henry. Okay.
Walter P. Henry, 614 Maple Avenue, Panama City, Florida. I was listening, and I think nobody make a move unless they know what their plans are, or either what they're going to do, or either what they're planning to do. Now, I said it once before. I know we done went in the business of buying property and just holding to it. For I don't know what reason or what or why we're doing it. I understand some of your problem, what you're doing. When they widened MLK, it took lots of property away. Now we want to see it to be built up. Only way it's going to be built up, it needs some more property to do that. You know, it's not just beating around the bush. We already know what we're planning to do with that property. If we go sit there and hold it, I already had noticed that somebody was interested in this property. The city will go rebuild, restructure this property and build houses on it. Yari, whatever. But we don't need to just try to feed folks anything. We know when all this happened, we know what we had, our plan was going to be. Somebody did. And somebody, if you're not being told, they was wrong. And the commissioner need to know when they get involved in things like this, what's going on, because the folks going to ask questions. And they're looking for an answer. And I don't blame them for that. I pastor the church, and when I do something, I know folks go answer, want to answer why I'm doing this, why you're doing it this way, and I got to have an answer for them. If I don't, I'm gonna tell them I'll find an answer if I don't know it myself. Be fair to the folks.
Thank you, Mr. Henry. All right, not seeing anyone else during the meeting. Thank you.